All right, now everybody take his kills, take his kills, take his kills. Nice, Beast.
Yeah, Beast.
Still going,
and
still going.
Scorchers?
What's going on, guys? It's your boy, your favorite gamer's favorite gamer with the most swag. Beast Mode Always, a.k.a. the Shift God, a.k.a. the Jump Shot Assassin, a.k.a. whatever I want to be, Call of Duty Hero. Yeah, I put the cape on in this Call of Duty thing. We back in the building, man. I've been hearing a lot of people struggling on these deatomizers, man. And here's the thing about that, guys. I recommend, man, if you guys want to get your deatomizer, want to get your first deatomizer, make sure you rock the MV4. That's like the easiest gun to get the deatomizer with. Now, I know it might be easy to some people, it might be hard to other people, but guarantee this. Check this out, chat. Check this out. Check what I'm about to say. When you get your first deatomizer, the next deatomizer, they're going to start coming just like this, back and back and back and back and back and forth. So, guys, when you go out here and try to get this deatomizer, man, make sure you just play your game, man. Have fun. Play your game. Rotate. Man, I played with some people yesterday. Shout out to that boy Jeff. Play with Jeff, man. That was his first time getting close like that. I think he was like 9 or 8 off. But the thing about it is, and he was frustrated, he raged it, and that's how you supposed to be. When your first deatomizer win, when you're going for your first deatomizer, if you like 9 or 5 off and you get killed, yes, rage. You supposed to rage, but guarantee one thing that's gonna happen. You got close, so that means you can get one. So that means you know how to play to get one. Whatever that map was, whatever that rotation was, man, you need to put that in your head and be like, look, I was close. I was there. Nobody else messed me up. I didn't mess up. I was there, and just the situation, you know, it put you in a situation where you just didn't get it. So, guys, when you go after these deatomizers, man, don't give up. Never stop. If you get killed once or twice, cool. That don't mean you have to stop. Still try to go at it. Still rotate. Still rock this MV4 for that first one. If you want to squad up with somebody, if you want to do it solo, man, that's up to you. Just get out here. Have fun. Pay attention to how people rotate. Pay attention to how people move. Watching this gameplay, man, watch the way I move. Watch the way I work the map. Watch the way I just, you know, my movement is, and I'm waiting on these guys. I bait these guys. I put them in one shot for the team kill. I either just sneak up on people. I get in. I get out. I make it happen. I make it do what it do. Next thing you know,
deatomizer.
And that's the thing about these deatomizers. Sometimes you can go at the deatomizers. Sometimes you don't go at the deatomizers. It just happened, and you might die a couple of times. But guess what? At the end of the day, you still gonna drop that bomb on these fools. So on this gameplay, man, I just want to show you guys, never give up, never stop. Keep it moving, keep it rotating, and you will drop that deatomizer. A lot of times I sit back and I be like, look, I'm not even going at the deatomizer. I'ma just play the game. I'ma just have fun. And next thing you know,
deatomizer.
I don't pay attention like I used to. Sometimes I even put on wrong guns. And then I'm like, dude, if I had to put on the right gun, I would have got a D-ad. Make no mistake. Straight out the rip, I would have got a D-ad. And it happens like that when you're trying to get deatomizers, when you have gotten a couple deatomizers, and when you just grinding, playing the game. A lot of times, dude, I just be in here playing the game. I just be chilling. I just be cool. And next thing you know, countdown. Deatomizer strike. And that's how it be. When you come around the corner, you pop somebody, deatomizer strike. And you just flowing with the map. Sometimes I play solo and I'm just playing. I'm trying to make a little clip. I'm trying to do a little something. Next thing you know, I'm 5 off. Next thing you know, deatomizer strike. So, you know, it's just one of them things, dude. So I recommend, guys, if you're going after the deatomizer strike, continue to go at it. Now, sometimes you may have to take a break because you find yourself getting frustrated. You're making the wrong decisions because you're just so anxious and you're just so mad and you're just so frustrated at yourself about getting a deatomizer. It don't matter if you're lobby hunting, if you're playing with a team or not. You just find yourself getting mad and getting angry, and you can get yourself burnt out by trying to get a deatomizer. When I tried to get my first deatomizer, I got so burnt out because I was just so hungry trying to get it. Now, I never tried to get it before my first one, so I sat back. I was like, you know what? I'm going to get this deatomizer. And it took me like 3 days. It took me 3 days on the first one trying to get, because before that, I was just making clips. I was just doing tutorials. I wasn't even caring about trying to get the deatomizer because I was playing different. Now, a lot of people look at my play style and the way that I play is like, dude, this, he plays a little passive. He plays aggressive. I play like, it's a means to my madness, if that makes sense, man. It's so many different ways I try and I can play the game. I can play competitively. I can play laid back. I can play, I guess, recreationally, if that's an even word. I can play sweaty. I can play passive. I can play different ways. So it all depends on what my competition is and what I'm trying to do for content. So like I say, a lot of times I don't even go at the deatomizer, and then I can get killed five off and be like, oh, okay, I got killed. Like somebody was like, dude, how do you be like, how are you so calm? You're like five off and you're so calm, because I'm not even going after the deatomizer. I wasn't going at it. I think on one gameplay I was on excessive, whatever the map is, and had the Moktov, and I'm just sitting in there and I'm just playing the game, and then I was like, oh dang, I'm on a 16 kill streak. I need to focus up. I wasn't even paying attention. And then I'm just sitting here talking, and somebody was like, I want to say it was that boy Ty Blandhaven, was like, dude, how are you just so laid back? I mean, you close on the deatomizer, how are you just so chill and laid back? I'm like, dude, when I went after that deatomizer with the trencher, the gamma trencher, dude, I almost pulled my hair out. It took me a day and a half to get that thing. I was one off. People was killing me. Two off. Game ending. One off or two off. And people leaving the lobby. We running around chasing at the one guy. I'm running around chasing at the one dude. I'm playing solo, two off. It was like, I have to say, it was like at least six games where I was one and two off in a row, and something happened, and I was stressing myself out. So I was like, you know what, man, when I'm going at the deatomizer, or if I'm close, I'm not doing that no more, man. I'm just going to chill. Guys, when you're going at the deatomizer, whether it's domination, infected, I don't know. I've never played infected. I'm hearing a lot of people say, man, hey, man, you need to go out there on infected. And I don't know. I might do infected. Who knows? But you know, I do it core. I think core, it for me is a better game to show your gun skill, you know, for me. And I like that. I like competition. I like stuff like that. I like dropping deatomizer on newbies, and I like dropping it on sweaties, and I like dropping it on master prestiges, so I can get some of that hate mail, because these boys be hating on your boy. So man, with all that being said, man, make sure y'all hit that like button. Hope y'all enjoy the gameplay. Make sure y'all comment below, and if you new to this channel right here, subscribe. It's your boy, Beast Mode, baby. Love y'all. I'm gone. Thank you.